Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. So in the previous session we have discussed about few concepts of chemical kinetics like rate of a reaction, rate constant, law of mass action, rate law, rate expression. Then we studied molecularity of a reaction, further types of reaction based on molecularity as unimolecular, bimolecular and intermolecular reactions, and even studied the order of a reaction. Further, we considered types of reaction based on even order of a reaction, that is zero order, first order, second order, third order, fractional order, pseudo order reactions, even pseudo unimolecular reactions with the respective examples. Well, in one of the case we come across the differences between rate of a reaction and rate constant. Well, what it says, rate of a reaction means it is the change in the concentration of any of the reactant or product with respect to time. Further, on the other side, what we said, rate constant is nothing but it is the rate of a reaction when concentration of all the reactant species involved in a rate law is taken as unity. So we consider the difference as like, okay. Well, here, whenever if I consider significance of a rate constant, significance of a rate constant, what we said, it is possible to predict the velocity of a reaction. What we said, higher the value of k indicates faster is the reaction, smaller the value of k indicates slower is the reaction. It means only by knowing the value of a rate constant, one can predict the nature of a reaction, whether the reaction is a fast reaction, slow reaction or moderate reaction. In the sense, we should be able to find out the K value, that is for any reaction, one, if anyone knows the K value, then it is possible to predict its nature. Then how to get the K value? Yes, we have a integrated rate equations, okay, for different ordered reactions to determine the value of K. Therefore, we say integrated rate equations for rate constant of a reaction. So with the help of integrated rate equations, yes, one can able to find out the K value. By knowing the K value, it is possible to predict the nature of a reaction. So in this session, we are going to deal with those integrated rate equations. Well, but the first one is the integrated rate equation, or I can say integrated rate equation for rate constant of a zero order reaction. So here I am considering the rate constant of a zero order reaction. Well, here, what is zero order? We already know the reaction in which rate of a reaction is independent of a concentration of reactant species. Or else, what is another way to define rate of a reaction? A type of a reaction in which rate of a reaction is directly proportional to zeroth power of a concentration of reactants. Well, consider a hypothetical equation R gives rise to product. We are going to derive an integrated rate equation for rate constant of a zero order reaction. Well, what is the first thing we have to consider? A hypothetical zero order reaction R gives rise to product. Well, as per the definition, what it says, the rate of a reaction is directly proportional to zeroth power of concentration of reactants. Therefore, I can say rate is proportional to concentration of R raised to zero. As per the definition, so we are converting that definition into a mathematical form. So rate is proportional to concentration of R raised to zero. Well, to remove the proportionality symbol, what is we are going to do? We are going to place a constant. So rate is equal to K into concentration of R raised to zero. So consider it is a equation one. Well, we know that differential form of a rate of a reaction can also be expressed in the form of change in the concentration of reactant, or you can say decrease in the concentration of reactant, or else increase in the concentration of a product with respect to time. Therefore, according to that concept, rate of a reaction can also be written as, so rate is equal to minus dr by dt. As I mentioned earlier, negative sign indicates the decrease in the concentration of reactant. So for a same reaction, rate can be expressed in two ways. According to rate law, rate is equal to K into concentration of R raised to 0. The differential form will be rate is equal to minus dr by dt. So equation means these two equations, equation 1 and 2, specifies the rate of a same reaction only. Therefore, what we can do, we can equate these two equations. That is, by equating 1 and 2, what I can say, minus dr by dt is equal to K into concentration of R raised to 0. Well, we know that anything raised to 0 is nothing but 1. Therefore, minus dr by dt is equal to K. On rearranging, dr is equal to minus K into dt. So it is the equation number 3. The equation is rearranged so that negative sign is taken on another side. Dr is equal to minus K into dt. So it is regarding equation 3. Well, if you integrate this equation, integration of dr, if you integrate on both sides, so integration of dr is equal to, since K is a constant, so we cannot integrate the constant values, so it is taken out of the integration. So minus K integration of dt. So integration of dr is equal to minus K into integration of dt. So integration of dr is nothing but r. So r is equal to, concentration of r is equal to minus K as it is. So integration of dt is nothing but t plus an integral constant I is added here. So it is the equation number 4. So r is equal to minus kt plus I. Equation number 4, here I is the integral constant. Well, to know the I value, we have to go for consideration. Well, what is that consideration? When t is equal to 0, what happens? Concentration of reactant will be its initial concentration. So I can say when t is equal to 0, concentration of reactant is nothing but its initial concentration. So initial concentration is abbreviated with the R naught. Now, if we substitute these things in previous equation, that is equation number 4, substituting the value of T and R in equation 4. So in the place of R, what you would write? R naught. So R naught is equal to minus K as it is. At the place of T, what is the thing? 0 plus I as it is. So that we got I value here. So if we simplify, what is the equation? R naught is equal to I, or I can say I is equal to R naught. What is that integral constant? Integral constant is nothing but initial concentration of a reactant itself, R naught. So if you substitute the I value in equation 4, what happens? Say R is equal to minus KT plus R naught. Okay, at the place of I, we are writing R naught, or else if you rearrange it, R naught minus R is equal to KT, or I can say KT is equal to R naught minus R, or K is equal to R naught minus R divided by T. So here, what is R naught? R naught is the initial concentration of reactant. R is the concentration of reactant at time T. What is K here? Rate constant of a zero order reaction. In the sense, by knowing the initial concentration of reactant and concentration of reactant at a time T, one can able to get the K value for a zero order reaction. Okay, so is it clear? It is regarding integrated rate equation for zero order reaction. So it will be asked for either 2 or 3 marks in the main examination. Well, we revise it once. So if they ask to derive the integrated rate equation for a zero order reaction, mean first, what is the thing? We have to consider a zero order reaction, hypothetical reaction. So let us consider a general zero order reaction of the type R gives rise to product. Then as per the definition, rate of reaction is directly proportional to zeroth power of concentration of reactant. Hence what we take, rate is proportional to concentration of R raised to 0. Further, to remove the proportionality symbol, what you use to place? A proportionality constant. What is that? Rate is equal to K into concentration of R raised to 0. So equation 1. And further, rate of reaction can also be written in the form of minus dr by dt. So equation number 2. So rate is equal to minus dr by dt, equation number 2. So both are specifying rate of a same reaction itself. Therefore, we are going to equate. So equating 1 and 2, what we have? Minus dr by dt is equal to k into concentration of r raised to 0. So anything raised to 0 is nothing but 1. Therefore, we have not considered here. So minus dr by dt is equal to k, or else dr is equal to minus k into dt. Equation number 3. Okay. Further, on integrating on both sides, what happens? Integration of dr is equal to minus k into integration of dt. So integration of dr is equal to r. So r is equal to minus k as it is. Integration of dt is equal to t. So r is equal to, concentration of r is equal to minus k into t plus I. Equation number 4. Here I is the a constant called integral constant. Okay. Further, to know the value of I, you have to consider when t is equal to 0, r is equal to r naught. Concentration of reactant is equal to initial concentration of reactant itself. Next, what we do? We are going to substitute the value of t and r in equation number 4. So r naught is equal to minus k into 0 plus I. On simplification, we get r naught is equal to I, or I can say I is equal to r naught. So we got the I value here. The value of I is substituted in the equation. So r is equal to minus kt plus r naught, or I can say kt is equal to r naught minus r, or k is equal to r naught minus r divided by t. So here k, rate constant of a zero order reaction, r naught, initial concentration of reactant, and r is the concentration of reactant at a time t. Well, I hope you understood this. So it is regarding integrated rate equation for rate constant of a zero order reaction. Well, similarly, as for our syllabus, even you have to study the integrated rate equation of first order reaction. Well, before going for that first order reaction, we consider the graphical representations, or I can say a graphical calculation of rate constant of a reaction. Well, what is that? Calculation of rate constant of a zero order reaction by graphical method. Well, here we know that for zero order reaction, what is the integrated rate equation? K is equal to r naught minus r divided by t. Or else I can say kt is equal to r naught minus r. Or else just we are rearranging the equation, that's it. So r is equal to minus kt plus r naught. What is the form we got? R is equal to minus kt plus r naught. Now this form of equation, this equation is compared with the equation of a straight line, that is y is equal to mx plus c. On comparison, what we get? We get the coordinates, we get the intercept as well as slope. Well, on comparison, the x coordinate will be t, that is time. Y coordinate will be concentration of reactant. Okay, it means if you plot a graph of concentration of reactant versus time, if you plot a graph of concentration of reactant versus time, what is the nature? We get a straight line with the slope. The slope is equal to minus k. M indicates the slope. So slope is equal to minus k, and intercept is equal to r naught. Means by knowing the concentration and time, that is change in the concentration, or I can say concentration of reactants at different intervals, by plotting a graph of concentration of reactant versus time, okay, the slope of the straight line gives the rate constant. Or else I can say k is equal to minus the slope. So whatever the straight line we get, if you calculate the slope of the straight line, the negative of that slope gives the, okay, minus into that slope gives the rate constant of a zero order reaction. In the sense, even by plotting a graph also, one can able to calculate the rate constant of a zero order reaction. So how it is possible? First, you have to consider the integrated rate equation of a zero order reaction. As I done here, k is equal to r naught minus r divided by t. It is rearranged to a form r is equal to minus kt plus r naught. So this equation is compared with equation of a straight line, so that we get coordinates, slope and intercept. So if you plot a graph of concentration versus time, we get a straight line. with slope is equal to minus k and intercept is equal to r naught. Okay, so it is regarding calculation of rate constant of a zero order reaction by graphical method. Okay, well, coming to the integrated rate equation for first order reaction, as like zero order, even we can consider the integrated rate equation of a first order reaction also. As like zero order, what it says, first order means here rate of a reaction is directly proportional to first power of concentration of reactant species. Okay, so to derive integrated rate equation, first again we have to consider hypothetical reaction equation. So let us consider a general first order reaction of type R gives rise to product. R indicates the reactant, it gives rise to product, and this reaction follows the first order kinetics. Order of this reaction is 1, that is n is equal to 1. Well, what the definition says, the rate of a reaction is directly proportional to first power of concentration of reactants involved in a rate law. Therefore, how I can write? Rate is proportional to concentration of reactant raised to 1, or else rate is equal to k into concentration of reactant raised to 1. As per the definition, rate of reaction is proportional to first power of concentration of reactants. That proportionality symbol is replaced by a constant k, that is rate constant of a first order reaction. So what is the equation we got for rate? Rate is equal to k into concentration of r raised to 1. So equation 1. So we know that rate of the reaction can also be expressed in different form, that is differential form. What is that? Rate is equal to minus dr by dt. So it is the equation number 2. Again, both equations specifies, that is equation 1 and equation 2, both specifies the rate of a same reaction itself. Therefore, what we are doing, we are going to equate equation 1 and 2. So if we equating 1 and 2, we have minus dr by dt is equal to k into concentration of r raised to 1. Okay, so earlier what you have done, in zero order, minus dr by dt is equal to k into concentration of r raised to 0 it is. So r raised to 0 is taken as 1. But now here, what is the difference? So minus dr by dt is equal to k into concentration of r raised to 1. 1 is there, so we cannot take it as a 1 quantity. So it is to be there. So minus dr by dt is equal to k into concentration of r raised to 1. Or else rearranging, since dr indicates small change in the concentration of reactant, the square bracket r also indicates concentration of a reactant itself. Therefore, these two terms are taken on one side. So on rearranging, dr by r is equal to minus k into dt. So it is the equation number 3. Further, we are going for integrating that equation. If you integrate on both sides, what is that? Integration of dr by r is equal to k is a constant, so minus k as it is, integration of dt. So on integrating, what we are getting? Integration of dr by r is equal to minus k into integration of dt. So integration of dr by r, or I can say integration of 1 by r into dr. What it is? Ln r. What is the formula? Integration of 1 by x into dx is equal to ln x. So accordingly, integration of 1 by r into dr is nothing but ln r. So ln r is equal to minus k. Integration of dt is nothing but t, so minus k into t plus I, a integral constant. It is the equation number 4. Okay, well, next, what is the next thing? To know the value of I, to get the value of integral constant, we are going for consideration. What is that? When t is equal to 0, at 0th time, it means reaction is not yet started, then what is the concentration of reactant? Is considered as initial concentration of a reactant. How it is abbreviated? With respect to symbol R naught. Okay, so what I can say, when t is equal to 0, R is equal to R naught.
these values, the value of t and r substituted in the equation number 4. So at the place of r, what I am writing? R naught. So ln r naught is equal to minus kt. At the place of t, we have to write 0. So ln r naught is equal to minus k into 0 plus I. Or else I can say ln r naught is equal to I, or I is equal to ln r naught. So we got I value here. So I is nothing but ln of r naught, initial concentration of a reactant. Next, what we are doing? The value of I is substituted in the previous equation. So substitute the value of I in equation number 4. So ln r is equal to, what is that equation 4? Ln r is equal to minus kt plus I. So ln r as it is, ln r is equal to minus kt plus I. At the place of I, what we are writing? Ln r naught. At the place of I, at this place there will be I, so is replaced by ln r naught. So what is the equation? Ln r is equal to minus kt plus ln r naught. So ln terms are taken on one side, so minus kt as it is, this ln r naught is taken on another side, so it will be ln r minus ln r naught. Ln a minus ln b is nothing but ln of a by b. So directly I have taken here, so ln of r naught by ln of r by r naught is equal to minus kt, or else ln of r naught by r, by interchanging these terms numerator to denominator, sign will be changes, so ln r naught by r is equal to kt. So what is the form we got? Ln r naught by r is equal to kt, or else I can say kt is equal to ln of r naught by r. We are equating for k, so k is equal to 1 by t ln of r naught by r. Further we know, what is ln? Ln is equal to 2.303 log. So instead of ln, what I can write? 2.303 log. So k is equal to 2.303 by t log of r naught by r. So it is the equation by which we can calculate the rate constant of a first order reaction. So what is the equation? K is equal to 2.303 by t log of r naught by r. So what is r naught here? Initial concentration of reactant. And what is r? Concentration of reactant at a time t. It means by knowing the r naught, r and t values, one can be able to calculate the rate constant of a first order reaction. Okay, so here what is k? Rate constant of a first order reaction. R naught, initial concentration of reactant, and r is the concentration of reactant at time t. So as I said, by knowing the initial concentration of reactant, concentration of reactant at time t, yes, one can calculate the rate constant of a first order reaction. Okay, it is regarding integrated rate equation for rate constant of a first order reaction. Well, so in other form also we can express the integrated rate equation for first order reaction. Well, what is the one form we got now? K is equal to 2.303 by t log of r naught by r. So terms involved, r naught, initial concentration of reactant, and r is the concentration of reactant at a time t. Okay, well, say let r is the a mole per liter. What is this r? R is the concentration at a time t. We are specifying that a concentration of reactant is a mole per liter. So in time t, x mole of reactants get changed into product. So what is this x moles? X moles is the number of moles of reactants consumed or reacted. Okay, what is r? R is the concentration of reactant left after the reaction. What is x here? X is the concentration of reactant, or I can say number of moles of reactants consumed at time t. So as I said here, in time t, x mole of reactants are converted into product. Then what I can say? the concentration of R left after time t, concentration of reactant left at time t or remains unreacted at time t will be A minus X. So A, out of which X mole will be reacted, so A minus X is the concentration of reactant left after time t. So now I can say, if A is the initial concentration of reactant, so R naught is equal to A moles per liter, and what is R? R is the A minus X, concentration of reactant remained or left after time t. What is A here? A is the initial concentration and X is the concentration of reactants consumed or reacted, or I can say converted into product. Well, and now other form, what we get? So at the place of R naught, what I can write? A. At the place of R, what I can write? A minus X. So is the another way of expressing integrated rate equation for first order reaction. So what is the equation? K is equal to 2.303 by T log of A divided by A minus X. What is A here? Remember, A is the concentration of reactant, initial concentration of reactant. X is the concentration of reactants consumed, reacted. Means by knowing the initial concentration as well as quantity of reactant consumed during a reaction, is even we can calculate the integrated rate equation, or I can say rate constant of a first order reaction. So it is the other form of integrated rate equation for first order reaction. Well, now if I consider graphically, as like for zero order we considered calculation of rate constant by graphical method, here also for first order also is it is possible to calculate the rate constant graphically. Well, one of the form we come across, what is that? Ln R is equal to minus kt plus ln R naught, means by substituting the I value we got this expression, ln R is equal to minus kt plus ln R naught. If this equation is compared with equation of straight line, what is the equation I considered? Ln R is equal to minus kt plus ln R naught is compared with equation of a straight line. On comparison, one can get the coordinates. What are the, say here, what is the y coordinate? Y coordinate will be ln R, x coordinate will be t. It means if we by plotting a graph of ln R versus time, what is the graph we are talking about? We are talking about a graph of ln R versus time. We get a slope. Slope is equal to minus k. Okay. And intercept is equal to ln R naught. So if you plot a graph of ln R versus time, we get a straight line. Okay. If you plot a graph of ln R versus time, we get a straight line with the negative slope. So that is slope is equal to minus k. R, I can say k is equal to minus slope. Means by plotting a graph of ln R versus time and by calculating the slope, so k is equal to minus into the slope. In the sense, graphically also we can calculate the k value. So here, what is the intercept? Ln R naught, the point which intersect the y coordinate, it gives the intercept, ln R naught. Okay, so even in the sense, even we can calculate rate constant of a first order reactions graphically. So by following this, well, next one, other form, like say we know the integrated rate equation, k is equal to 2.303 by t log of R naught by R, concentration of reactants. Just we are rearranging it. So on rearranging, we are equating for log of R naught by R. So log of R naught by R is equal to kt by 2.303. Say denominator multiplied with k. So kt is present with multiplication, so goes to denominator. So what is the rearranged form? Log of R naught by R is equal to kt divided by 2.303. Now this rearranged equation is compared with the equation of a straight line. That is y is equal to mx plus c. Again, what is the y coordinate here? Log of R naught by R. What is the x coordinate? t. What is the slope? K divided by 2.303. Okay. Well, when you look at the graph, log of r naught by r versus time. Okay. If you plot a graph of log of r naught by r versus time, you get a straight line with positive slope. So slope is equal to k divided by 2.303. Or else, if I equate for k, what is that? K is equal to 2.303 into slope. Means coordinates log of r naught by r versus time. Slope is equal to k by 2.303 we get. So by equating k, k is equal to 2.303 into slope. Whatever the straight line we get, if you calculate the slope of this and is multiplied with the 2.303, the resultant value will be k, rate constant of a first order reaction. So it's the another way of calculating, that is graphical method itself by which we can calculate the k value for first order reaction. Well, one more important thing. Say here, another form I consider, LAN form. That is, in the first case, we consider LAN. We know that LAN is nothing but 2.303 log. Just I changed it. So LAN, instead of LAN, I'm considering 2.303 log. So LAN R is equal to minus KT plus LAN R naught. Now what I can consider? Instead of LAN, 2.303 log of R is equal to minus KT as it is, plus 2.303 log of R naught. Okay. So we have, instead of LAN, wherever LAN comes, at the place we are taking 2.303 log. Now, common with the two terms, 2.303 is common. Therefore, we are going to divide each term with 2.303. So, first term, 2.303 log R divided by 2.303 is equal to minus KT divided by 2.303 plus 2.303 log R naught divided by 2.303. It means divide each term with 2.303. So, what we get in the first case? 2.303 cancels, so remaining will be log R is equal to minus KT by 2.303 plus in the third term also 2.303 cancels, so remaining will be log R naught. So we got the expression log R is equal to minus KT by 2.303 plus log R naught. Now this is compared with the equation of a straight line, y is equal to mx plus c. Now the coordinates, y coordinate is log R naught, x coordinate again t, and what is the slope we get? Minus k by 2.303, and what is the intercept? Log r naught. So here also, by plotting a graph of whatever the coordinates I said, log r versus t. Okay, if you plot a graph of log of r, concentration of reactant versus time, you get a straight line with slope is equal to minus k by 2.303 and intercept is equal to log r naught. Okay. Coordinates log r by t, we get a straight line with slope is equal to minus k by 2.303 and intercept will be log r naught. Again, if you equate for k, so k is equal to minus 2.303 into slope. So whatever the straight line we get, if you calculate the slope and is multiplied with the minus 2.303, we get the k value. So this is one more graphical method to calculate the rate constant of a first order reaction. Well, now the other form, exponential form of the, okay, instead of LAN, one can consider the exponential form of a integrated rate equation for first order reaction. So again, I consider LAN R is equal to minus KT plus LAN R naught. So we can write LAN of R naught by R is equal to minus KT. Now, if you take anti-log, if you take anti-log on both sides, so anti-log of LAN of R by R naught is equal to minus K anti-log of KT, or I can say anti-log of minus KT. So LAN anti-log cancels, so remaining will be R by R naught is equal to, so anti-log of minus KT, how I can write? Exponential form, so e raised to minus KT. Or else R is equal to R naught into e raised to minus KT. So we get a one more formula which relates rate constant with the concentration of a reactant species. So R is equal to R naught into e raised to minus kt. So R, concentration of reactant at time t, R naught initial concentration, and here k, rate constant of a first order reaction. Okay. Well, it's regarding integrated rate equation for zero order and first order reactions, and few important things to be remembered. That is, graphically how we can calculate rate constant of a zero order as well as first order reactions, and some other important concept. Okay. Well, I hope you understood all these concepts. Again, in the next session, we deal with some other concept of a chemical kinetics. Thank you.
Thanks for watching.
Like,
comments,
share,
and
subscribe.